Muertos is the celebration of life and death. And it comes from Latin American roots and traditions. It's predominantly known here in the U.S. through the Mexican roots that it holds. But other Latin American countries celebrate it, and it's usually celebrated starting October 31st, and it goes until November 2nd. And it folks usually celebrate in various ways, parties, but the most traditional way that people celebrate is through the altar and the altar. And what it means to me is I'm specifically from the culture. I identify as a Mexican from Mexico, and I just grew up knowing that that was something that we were always going to do, is put the altar up, put pictures of folks who have passed and that we knew, that loved ones. And how it's traditionally done is you place water, you place salt, you place marigolds, you place pictures of loved ones, and then you put their favorite food. So it's usually whatever they love to eat. And then it's usually pan de muerto, which is a specific bread that is made only during this time, that goes on the altars. And then you don't eat it. But when I was a little kid, I remember always wanting to like steal the candy off of the altar or like eat it. And my mom would be like, okay, I'll give you a little piece and like let me eat it. But you're not supposed to be doing that. But I was a little kid, I didn't know back then.
A wonderful celebration, and again, for those of you that don't know, my name is Renee Sanchez. I'm the advisor to Mecha with Dr. Santana. I'm also a theology professor, so for me, the theological significance of Dia de los Muertos is really an understanding that life and death, that veil is so thin, that we really are in the company always of our ancestors, our loved ones, and that really life has this larger meaning than just material life, that really we're connected through time and space beyond our understanding through love. For the time being, I just put up my pictures of my father and my mother who have since passed away, and I carry them in my heart. I love them, they love me, and somehow, after grieving their loss, I came to realize that the love that we have for each other is beyond death. It's stronger than death. And this Dia de los Muertos is a reminder of that for all of us. And I think, I'll say the last thing is, I think it's especially important in the United States because we're a country that sometimes, like it or not, denies death. We want to pretend we're going to live forever, whether it's through Botox or surgeries or whatever. And here we're saying, no, we'll live forever, but not in this fake, superficial way, but in the deep way of celebrating with all our sisters and brothers here in this hall and even beyond that. So.
This event has been going on at the University of Portland for quite some time, and it has actually grown so much that it used to be held in St. Mary's, and now it's on the quiet side of the Commons just because of the size of the event. And so it's been really exciting to work with the diversity coordinators on planning it, teaching them about the significance of every little piece to it, and then getting to incorporate the community to come on campus. So we actually have two community performances, Aztec dancers who are going to come and close the show for us, and then we have this traditional dance that is danced on the Day of the Dead, and it's called Danza de Viejitos, and so it's just kind of, it's celebrating our elders in the community, and so it's a specific dance where the elders dance, and it's traditionally done with little kids, so little kids will dress up as elders, and it's really cute. They'll like dance around, and we're having them do our sugar schools. So there's gonna be sugar school decorating, and the local high school students are doing them for us and then coming to our event. So they're really excited about coming to campus, hanging out with college students, and getting to teach them how to do the decorating of the sugar schools. And so that's kind of the mentality that's around Dia de los Muertos. And then when you translate it to Day of the Dead, it takes on this connotation of, oh, you know, it's sad, it's morbid, or something along those lines. And really, that's not what it, that's the unfortunate part of translating things. It kind of loses its essence.
I am personally Mexican-American, and Dia de los Muertos has always been not so celebrated in my family, but coming to UP, I attended all the events for it over the years, and I wasn't too happy with how it played out. But this year I'm actually super excited because not only am I working as a diversity coordinator, I am also working with Yuri Hernandez, who is a Latina woman. And bringing the authenticity to this event has just made me super happy that my heritage is being made aware.
I'm very excited to learn about other traditions and other cultures as well, hosted here at the university. And today for Dia de los Muertos, it's something near and dear to our background and our family and where we're coming from. And I'm very excited to learn about other cultures as well.
And I can't wait to celebrate this evening to remember my grandparents, his grandparents, and just thank University of Portland for having this tonight.
Dia de los Muertos is important to me because it stands for my heritage and helps me stay informed and stay involved with my Mexican roots.
We bring Dia de los Muertos to campus because there's folks who identify from that tradition, and we definitely want to highlight that and say you don't need to go elsewhere to get those traditions. They're within our community. People here are knowledgeable in this area, and so let's celebrate that, and let's also bring out community members so that they feel welcome to our campus.